So class, now I think you all must have understand about timings of the tides, how the timings of the tides change daily. Yes? Yes? Okay. Now before we start with our next topic, that is waves, let us just have a quick revision, okay, on what we have seen about the tides. Clear all of you? Please listen carefully. First, centrifugal force, okay, then gravitational force, okay. Okay, now you all must have understood what is centrifugal force and gravitational force. Now what are the factors responsible for the occurrence of tides? Come on, you all are going to tell me the answer. Factors responsible for the occurrence of tides. Yes class? Come on. Okay, so what are the factors? First, the gravitational pull of the moon and the sun as well as that of the earth. Yes. Then revolution of the earth around the sun and the indirect revolution of the moon around the sun. Yes. Then centrifugal force generated due to rotation of the earth. These are the factors responsible for the occurrence of tides. Yes. Then nextly we have seen that what are tides. Yes, so in that we saw two types of tides. What are the two types of tides? Yes, what are the two types of tides? Spring tide and neap tide. Yes, on the new moon day and full moon days, the gravitational pull of the sun and the moon act in the same direction, leading to spring tides. Yes, the gravitational pull is in the same direction. Okay, sun, moon and earth, they are in same direction. So gravitational pull is in the same direction. So that gives occurs to which tide? Which tide? Spring tides. Very good. Then spring tides are higher than the average high tides and lower than the average low tides. So these are spring tides. What are neap tides? On the first and the third quarter day of each month, the forces of both the sun and the moon operate at right angles of the earth, leading to neap tide. Yes, forces, okay, of sun and moon are in the right angle. And when the positions are like this, when it is on the first and third quarter day. Yes, so this gives occurrence to the neap tide. Neap tides are little lower than the average high tides and a little higher than the average low tide. So these are high tide and, sorry, these are spring tide and neap tide. Understood? Then we saw effects of tides. What are the effects of tides? Quickly, come on, tell me. With the high tides, fish move into the creeks and this helps fishing activity. The tides clear the west and hence the coasts become clean. Due to tides, ports do not get filled with sediments. Yes, ships can move up to the ports during high tide. During high tide, seawater can be stored in salt pans from which salt can be obtained. The tidal force can be used to generate electricity. The tides help in maintaining the mangroves and the coastal biodiversity. A lack of understanding of the timing of high tide and low tide may cause accidents to swimmers entering the sea. So these all were the things which we have seen. And the lastly, timings of the tides change daily. How do they change? Okay, so tides occurs after every 12 hours and 25 minutes. Why does this change happen? That we have seen. Okay, now next we are going to see is waves. Okay, before in the last session I told you about one activity: take water in one plate and try to give waves. So how can you wave it? What are the waves? If we blow it, it can get waves. Okay, so if you, here it is, If you blow air over hot milk or tea while drinking, ripples. What is it? Ripples are generated on the milk or tea. In the same way, because of the force of wind, water appears to be moving. This water which you can see, which we see, which appears to be moving. Why is that water moving? Because of the force of the wind. Okay. Water appears to be moving. The sea water gets pushed by the wind and ripples are generated on the water surface. These are called waves. So what are these? These are because of the force, because of the wind, the waves get generated into the sea water. Okay. The sea water moves up and down or slightly forward and backward. What? The sea water moves up and down or slightly forward and backward due to the waves. Okay. What? These sea waters, they move up and down or slightly forward. We can see it comes forward, goes backward, comes forward, goes backward due to the waves. The waves bring the energy contained in them or to the coast. What? The waves bring the energy contained in them to the energy means if we are going to push, okay, what happens? The front, whatever the front water is there, it comes front and then it goes back. They break in the shallow waters near the coast. Large or small waves are formed continuously at the surface of the sea. Generation of waves is a natural and regularly occurring phenomena too. You can see in this figure how the waves are there, and if you have seen, if you have gone to the sea coast, you will understand it in a better way. Okay, understood all of you? Waves. Okay, now how are the structures of these are how the structures of waves are. See, you can see here how are the waves. Okay, the sea water get pushed up and down because of wind. See, up and down, up and down. Okay, so the raised up portion of the wave is called crest. Raised up portion is called crest, and the depressed one is called trough. T-R-O-U-G-H. You can see over here in this picture, class. So the raised up portion is crest, and the portion which is down is trough. If a strong wind is blowing in one direction, large waves are generated. Okay, the vertical distance between a crest, the vertical distance between a crest and the following trough is called the amplitude of the wave, whereas the distance between the successive crest of troughs is called wavelength. Can you see over here? See, class, look over here. What? This distance, like this distance between two waves is called as wavelength, and this distance, okay, where the wave is move upward, okay, from the bottom, it is called as the, what is called as amplitude of the wave. What it is called as? Amplitude of the wave. Got all of you? See, this is called, the upper portion is called crest. The portion which has gone down is called trough. This direction between two waves is called wavelength, and the distance, this vertical distance, is called as the amplitude of the wave. Okay, so the wavelength, its amplitude and its velocity depend on the velocity of wind. Okay, the wavelength, its amplitude and its velocity depend on the velocity of wind. So you all can understand this between this figure 3.11. Try to understand it in a proper way. Okay, class. Now, after this, we are going to see what is velocity of waves. Okay. If we stand on the coast, if you all are going to stand on the coast, we feel the waves. Okay. If you are standing on the coast, the water, it comes. Okay. And you can feel the waves are coming towards the coast. If a floating object is thrown at a distance in the sea, we find the object moving up and down at the same place. Okay. If you throw something light object on the sea, in the sea at a distance. Okay. So you can see that object, it is just moving with the waves. What that object is just moving, coming forward with the wave. Getting? Why does this happen? It does not come to the coast. It means the water forming the wave also does not come to the coast. That means in middle, okay, the water which is forming the wave, it does not come at the coast. Only the water which is on the coast, it is just move forward, it goes backward. The water which is on the coast, it comes forward, goes backwards. Okay, remember that the water in the wave does not move. What moves in the energy? Whatever moves is not the water. What moves is the energy. Okay.